In this tutorial, we'll show you how to configure foreign exchange rate and amount overrides for historical accounts in Oracle Tax Reporting Cloud. You can override the current period foreign exchange rates and amounts for book accounts that require historical rates. Book accounts are located under the income statement and balance sheet hierarchies in the account dimension. During currency translation, you can use a historical exchange rate in place of the current period exchange rate. Alternatively, you can use the historical translated amount for the current period translated value, in which case currency translation does not take place. To configure an account to use historical override rates or amounts, you edit the account's exchange rate type property. I'll configure the common stock account to use historical exchange rates by selecting historical rate override. I'll configure paid in capital to use an amount override by selecting historical amount override. When you select historical rate override or amount override for an account, the account is automatically added as a shared member to the FCCS historical accounts hierarchy. The base level accounts in the FCCS historical accounts hierarchy display on the FX rates override form, which you use for entering rates. After changing member properties, you need to refresh the database in order to apply your changes. To enter override rates and amounts, open the FX rates override form. In the POV, select the entity for which to enter historical rates. The form displays rows for all historical accounts in the FCCS historical accounts hierarchy. For historical rate override accounts, the rate override column is available and the amount override column is read-only. You enter rates to translate from the base currency of the entity in the POV to the currencies in the rows. For common stock, I'll enter a rate of 0.85 as the historical rate to translate from Canadian dollars to US dollars for all periods. Rates and amounts for historical overrides are stored in the console cube, so if you are loading rates from a file or using data management, you should make the console cube your target. For amount override accounts, the amounts override column is available and the rates override column is read-only. You enter the translated value to use for the account. For paid in capital, I'll enter 800,000 in the amount override column as the US dollars translated value for the account for all periods. It's not necessary to run the compute rates rule after you enter override rates and amounts, since no triangulation is involved. In this tutorial, we showed you how to configure foreign exchange rate and amount overrides for historical accounts in Oracle Tax Reporting Cloud. To learn more, visit cloud.oracle.com.